Hey, this is Dr. Paul. I just wanted to share with you. I'm actually just finishing an expert witness testimony here in Chicago, flying back home. Literally just got off the stand about an hour or two ago for this major personal injury case. And what I wanted to share with you is why, if you're injured, you need to do two things. You need to get an attorney, and then you need to find a doctor who's been educated and how to document personal injury cases. And let me share with you why, because this is so classic what happened. So this patient that we testified for, he paid his insurance premiums. The person who hit him paid his insurance premiums. So he gets hit from behind by a vehicle about 3,000 pounds going 40 miles an hour. That's a major collision. Well, he has major permanent damage in his neck. We showed and documented and all that. So what did the insurance company want to do? They didn't even want to pay his medical bills. The person in that car who caused the accident, he paid their premium all these months. The person I testified for, who has the permanent injury, he paid his premiums. Of course, it had nothing to do with his insurance, but was interesting, it was the same insurance company. So they don't even want to pay his medical expenses from a permanent injury that he paid. That's why you need to see a doctor. And I'll tell you the other reason why. These injuries are always missed. Like this patient, he goes to the emergency room, they do a CAT scan, they do an EKG, they do blood tests. They were all the wrong test. They didn't even find the problem because they were all the wrong test for the problem. So they give him medication, release him. He still continues to have problems. He continues to have problems because he suffered a major injury and they missed the diagnosis because they didn't do the right test. And I'm just sharing with you, this happens all the time. So then he goes to his general practitioner. What's his medical doctor do? Same thing, he does EKG for a neck problem. He's doing blood work and an EKG. Those are the absolute wrong tests. He doesn't find the problem. So what's he do? He gives him more medication. Problem continues. Goes to another doctor. Finally ends up at a chiropractor about a year later. Well, the problem with that is we heal. We go through three phases of healing, and within a certain time period, we'll actually start healing wrong. I mean, we're going to heal, but we'll heal wrong, and that's what started happening. So he started getting the physical medicine too late, is what happened. And because of that, and in my opinion, he would have suffered a permanent opinion anyway because of how severe the injury was. It just wouldn't have been as bad if he'd have gotten chiropractic physical medicine right at the time. But because he'd already started healing wrong, it magnified the permanency is what it did. So anyway, problem continues. Well, it continues because it's permanent now. So what do? Then they want to send him over and to a pain specialist that wants to do... that wants to cut his nerves. Cut his nerves. That's a radical procedure. And finally he said, no, I'm not doing that. Well, believe it or not, a lot of patients don't know any better and they just follow that medical route. Next thing you know, they're getting their nerves cut, they're getting surgery, and it's not even necessary if they'd have gotten physical medicine, such as chiropractic. And we see this all the time. So that's exactly what happened in this case. So he's not referred. None of those doctors referred him to a chiropractor. Emergency room didn't. General practitioner didn't. The other general practitioner, none of them did. He accidentally went on his own. And that's typically what happens. And unfortunately with us, when we see the patients, it's typically 3, 4, 5, 10 years later when it's already permanent, old, and now they're having a lot of problems. And they wouldn't have had as many problems or any problems at all if they'd had the physical medicine within the three phases of healing within a few weeks to months right after that injury. So here you go. That's what happens. What happened to him, I saw in practice all the time. And by the time they finally get the appropriate physical medicine, it's too late. Now we can help them. We can make them feel better and move a little better, but it's permanent. It's going to come back, and then he has to get treated again. It's going to come back, and he's got to get treated again. Where if he'd have been treated... And a lot of times these patients, we can treat them while they're healing to where they don't have a permanent injury. They actually get the physical medicine necessary to get it back to normal. And of course, that's the goal. But anyway, I just wanted to share with you. When you're in an accident, go find a chiropractor, but not any chiropractor. You got to find a chiropractor who's had training in personal injury, because it's a very, it's a specialty. It's a specialty. And definitely get an attorney. I recommend it, Ed, because here's why. These insurance companies, they probably still do, right after an accident, they would call the patient, offer them $500 to settle the case right then. Well, the patient wouldn't know any better. And a lot of them would just take the money. And now they have nothing for medical expenses or for that injury from that day forward. In other words, those insurance companies know what they're doing. And they're cheating. They're cheating is what they're doing. They take all the premiums, and then they don't want to pay when somebody has the problem. That's why you need an attorney. So, and that's why I always referred my patients to a good personal injury attorney. Because as soon as you get a good personal injury, that stuff stops. That crap stops. And then you need a good doctor who's been trained in personal injury that understands the three phases of healing to apply the proper physical medicine to decrease the likelihood of a permanent injury to some degree the rest of your life. That's the best way to get it out of it with the least likelihood of a permanent injury and get all your bills paid. And if you have any permanent injury, future bills paid. But that is not the norm. 8, 9 out of 10 people, they don't see the doctor. They just, or if they do, it's just a medical doctor and they just get pain pills. They heal wrong. They get no physical medicine. And then the insurance company doesn't want to pay anything and don't even want to pay all the bills. And they definitely don't want to pay anything in the future. That's what happens 9 out of 10, 10 out of 10, 9 out of 10, 8 out of 10 times. Because the patient doesn't know any better. That's why you should always, when you're in an accident, get evaluated first by a doctor who's had certification and documentation in personal injury, so he knows the tests that need to be done. In the example I use, this patient went to 4 different medical doctors, emergency room, 2 medical doctors, and a pain specialist, 4 doctors. None of them diagnosed his injury because they didn't have the typical fracture, broken bone. So, anyway, I just wanted to share that with you. If you're in an accident, find a chiropractor that knows personal injury, especially with the spine, and then definitely get an attorney to protect yourself. Those guys are bastards. They're just bastards. They just want to hand out a $500 check and not pay for anything, and then now you pay all these premiums, and now they don't even want to cover you. Get it taken care of.